So initialize a list a way to actually support you to specify a list of many potential inputs at construction time of such a template object. So they are very similar to our basic arrays in C and C++. So what you can do in C and C++, right? You can say I have an array list and I say here I don't know how many elements it has, but it is an array. And then I, on the right-hand side, provide all the values that should be stored in this array. But that's very simple and much easier compared to our idea here to push all these numbers into it if I already know the inputs that should be stored in such a vector, right? So, yeah, you can do the same in C++, starting with C++ 11. So we can say I have a vector of strings, for example, and I call this vector list. And then on the right hand side, I use our curly brackets and I say this list contains of two strings, right? It contains of hello and CS1PR16, for example. So that's really the same notation as here, but it works now as well as for containers that use templates. So how can we use this in our own class? Well, let's call this class my class. And in this class, in the constructor, I have to use a template called initializerList, and I have to specify what kind of arguments I expect. So this is of course part of the standard library, so I have to include it. And now when I specify an instance, I can say, well, this instance here, this object should be initialized with, here in this case, three float values, and those three float values are given here to the function, and then I can pull out the data. So there are many more types in containers. String is a very basic type that under the hood uses the vector to handle text strings. Pair that we declared is almost the type that is provided by C++. The idea is that we can bind together multiple types without defining a structure, but they are unnamed. So we have always a first and a second element, basically, but not a student and a student ID or something like that. For that, you still need a struct. But as long as you just want to return, for example, from a function, more than one element, you can use this convenience type pair to say, I want to return an integer and a string, for example, at the same time. So we can now do this. In C, it was not possible without using declaring a structure for such a return type. Now we can just use pair. Extending from pair with C++ 11, you can use tuples that binds together any number of types. So I can have pairs basically, which are tuples to 4, 6, 8 elements.